Law library. I love all the faculty I've met, and I'm telling you, Oregon's amazing. It's like 70 degrees sunny.
You're not going to win a weather war, sweetie. It's 70 degrees and sunny every day here in LA.
Yeah, I don't know. But when I tell you it's beautiful, it's like seriously beautiful. I mean, you can actually see mountains, and the sky's blue, not some brown or gray. And the trees are incredible.
Oh, come on, we have trees.
Well, that's not like a contest. I'm just saying it's really nice.
Yeah. The grass is always greener.
Yeah, well, I'm telling you, the grass actually is greener here.
What the hell's going on?
It says they've got like 3 blocks closed.
What for?
They're filming something.
Maybe we should take the freeway.
It says the freeway's worse.
How could it be worse than that movie?
Maybe you go backwards.
Captain wants to know why we don't have any suspects in those cases.
Get my psychic powers for failing me.
Well, maybe we should take out a billboard. Stop killing each other till we catch up. Sign the police.
Yes, leave more evidence.
Hey, you wanna grab a bite?
I think I'm gonna head up the park.
Park?
Yeah.
What for?
Go for a run.
A run?
Yeah. I'll look at something beautiful. We got views in this city, right? That's why we live here.
Hell if I know.
I open them and I wake up my son.
And this has been happening since the accident?
So you begin working on one case here in reality, and then suddenly you begin working another case there in your dream.
It all feels completely real to me.
You can't tell whether you're awake or asleep at this very moment.
Well, I can assure you, Detective Britton, this is not a dream.
It's exactly what the other shrink said.
This all of them?
1999 to last year. Everyone gets a vertical slash down the wrist after they bleed out a postmortem Roman numeral 2 carved into their torso. You got all pairs, 2 in Minneapolis, Nashville, Buffalo, Philadelphia, Lincoln, Ann Arbor, Dallas, and then a year later, LA, last night. Vic disappeared yesterday. Got a witness, nothing from forensics yet. And to ignore the fact Gemini's dead, it fits his pattern to a T.
So, what, either he's been resurrected and is leaving bodies in Griffith Park, or someone found his work inspirational enough to copy.
You know, the Gemini always killed his second victim within 48 hours and left it in a paired location.
2 cars in Nashville, 2 bathrooms in Dallas. So this victim turns up in the park. If the copycat's as good as he looks, there'll be another one in another park.
Well, there's, what, 70,000 acres of parkland in L.A.? Are you suggesting that we shut it all down?
Oh, we gotta do something. Maybe beef up patrols the next couple of days, put canine units on the entrances and exits.
Son, who's getting the fed?
Why are they sending someone?
I asked for forensics in the previous cases. FBI told me an agent would be on the next plane.
Ask for an email. They book a plane ticket. Gotta love the government.
Who do you work for? Google?
Look, I'm just asking you to help me out. She's my daughter, too.
What do you want me to do, Elizabeth? Drive her? I can't force her to get on the phone.
Did she at least get the package?
Why do you do this to yourself? You know she's trying to hurt you.
I gotta go. I'll call you back. Divorce sucks. You are Detective Britton, right?
Yeah.
Elizabeth Santoro.
Good to meet you.
You mean the case file?
Yeah, it's in the car. Shall we?
It's a copycat story, you guys. Pretty good.
You're positive it's a copycat?
Am I positive?
Just asking.
How many cases have you had in the last 12 years, Detective Britton?
I don't know. Hundreds.
Well, I've had one. The Gemini Killer.
Well,
you know what they give you after 12 years on one case?
Nope.
Book deal. So ever since last May, I've been sitting in a cabin in Portland trying to get the last 12 years down on paper, hoping that when the hardcover comes out, it'll all seem worth it. The short and soon-to-be declassified answer will be on page 27. Anybody ever reads the stupid book?
I should.
No $2 bill.
$2 bill?
Gemini always left a $2 bill in the hand of his victims. You know, to Gemini twin sign. He kept it from the press to separate imitators and false confessors from the real thing. You guys find a $2 bill I don't know about?
No.
There you go. Copycat. And that's the other unfortunate consequence of spending 12 years with one particular sicko. You're the person to get out of bed every time another one turns up. Still, it gets me out of Portland for a while.
I hear it's nice up there.
Who told you that? All it ever does is rain. Imagine London, but full of hippies. You coming in?
I have something to sort out. I'll see you up there.
So, did you meet Santoro?
Meet her? She's not there 10 minutes, and she already telling us we're looking for a disgruntled white dude, middle to lower middle class. Based on what exactly? She don't say. These profilers, man, they just a cut below psychics. They make these broad generalizations that apply to almost anybody, then congratulate themselves for being right no matter what turns up.
I had no idea it was such a sore point for you.
Well, let's just say I've been accidentally pulled over enough to know that there's a difference between a profiler and a suspect. Hey, is this it? This is it right here?
Browner, pointier, muddier.
Look, I'm just saying real cops. Don't sit back and theorize about whether a suspect likes bingo or eats cornflakes. I mean, we pound the pavement. We work the dog biscuits, baby.
Oh, hey. Here, boy. Here's a good boy. Tasty. Come on. Come to daddy.
You guys should keep him after sedation wears off. Help cheer this place up.
Yeah, morgue mascot. Just what we need. You know, this little jerk tried to bite my finger off earlier. You know, gastric lavage on an anesthetized dog? Not my job.
I know you are.
Yeah, you do. That said, American currency has plastic security threads woven into the paper. It makes them hard to digest. It's a little ragged, but there's no question. That's a $2 bill.
This does not mean it's the Gemini. It just means the copycat is someone who had access to classified information about the case. If anything, it helps us narrow our profile to someone who's probably in or was let go from law enforcement. Can we get records of any LAPD recently fired, demoted, or laid off, and anybody with a psychiatric history? We'll go through them, start a canvas, ASAP. Maybe somebody connects back to our victim. Sound good?
Look, what if it were the Gemini Killer?
The Gemini Killer is dead, Detective. I shot him myself.
Actually, a man named Arthur Minturn is dead. Now, you're saying he's a Gemini because he fits the profile?
No idea what you're talking
about. Saying if you happen to be wrong, then we'd be wasting our time interviewing recently fired cops when we should be looking for a guy who's been at this for more than a decade.
Your call, Captain. I'm just here to consult. All right, pull the files.
Yes, ma'am.
Agent Santoro.
Look, all Bird's asking is if there is value in at least considering the possibility that it's not a copycat.
I had no trouble parsing what he was saying. Maybe I had trouble with my answer.
Look, I understand the implications. Honestly, I put an innocent man in jail for 10 years. Something I have to live with. Mistakes happen. It's part of the job.
I'm sorry you made a huge mistake, Detective. Sorry if that mistake probably ruined someone's life. I'm sorry if it still keeps you up at night. But I'm here to prevent another victim from appearing on your board tomorrow. Good night.
Hey, honey, it's me. Listen, I can't find my phone charger, so if you have any idea where it is, will you call me? Even if you don't, you can still call me.
You're saying you feel lied to?
No, I'm saying that apparently the people at Mountaintop Movers knew she was more serious about this than I did.
How did she give you the impression she wasn't serious?
Look, we talked about it. She's just visiting. It's not a realistic option.
Is that what she's been saying, or is that what you've been hearing? Confirmation bias makes us susceptible to hearing only things that reinforce our opinion. And the more closely held our opinion, the more selective we seem to be about the things that we pay attention to.
I think I know what we've discussed. You never mentioned calling the movers. Trust me.
Can we just try something, just for a minute? I want you to try to think about how Hannah would describe her situation.
Oh, come on, I'm not gonna role play.
You don't have to be Hannah, per se, but I just want you to try to imagine where she is right now and see if you can articulate how she would describe things from her point of view. Close your eyes.
You're kidding me.
Please.
Fine. What do you want to know?
Tell me what it's like where Hannah is.
It's Oregon, so it's pretty. Mountains, whatever.
Do you imagine that Hannah seems happy?
Happy? Yeah, I guess.
And why do you think that is?
Because she likes the idea of starting over.
And why is that so appealing?
Because it's easier than staying here and dealing with everything.
No, that is what you would say. What would Hannah say?
I guess she would like things to be good again.
And what does that mean? Okay, let me put it this way. When Hannah imagines things being good again, are you a part of it?
What do you mean by that?
I guess I'm wondering if your fear is less about the idea of Hannah leaving Los Angeles and more about the idea of Hannah leaving you.
That's way off.
You said that even before the accident, things were less than ideal between the two of you. We have discussed the very real fact that a large number of marriages don't survive the loss of a child, and yet you pretend that the idea of your relationship being in jeopardy doesn't even occur to you.
It doesn't have to occur to me, does it? I got you to point out my marriage is falling apart.
Unfortunately, Detective, the reality is that this is the way most marriages die. Not with epic rounds of screaming matches, not with threats or ultimatums, but with two people who wander slowly away from one another. Without a word. They completely forget what it really means to be together until one day they look up and they discover they're so far apart, there's no way back.
Hey, I may have a lead on that Hancock Park home invasion. I'm meeting with some guy who says he knows the fence. Wouldn't mind a second opinion, see if he's for real. Unless you're busy.
I'm good.
Oregon? What the hell are you gonna do in Oregon? I don't think I could ever leave LA. LA's perfect.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I went out with an actress the other day who asked me to help her memorize lines. She said the only way that she could get into the part was to strip away everything that wasn't part of the character. So she gets naked and reads a script to me for an hour and a half. I mean, you cannot find that in Oregon.
She read to you.
Naked.
You and I have different definitions of perfect.
Wait, hold on. Hold on. Here it is. I don't understand. It's supposed to be here. My informant said it was a punch-up.
Who introduced you to the CI?
Nobody. I was on a follow-up. He came right up and said he might know something.
Came up to you?
Yeah, for $100, he said he'd tell me where it was. What? You
just learned a $100 lesson. If you have to buy it, it may be information. If they try and sell it to you, it's always BS.
I don't suppose the department is going to help me out with that $100.
Think of it as a rookie tax.
Mud flap in?
Forensics and Gemini's other cases suggest you like to set up a base within a 2-mile radius of the first kill. Get to know the area. Cheap hotels with classy names.
The sort of place nobody asks questions if you walk in with blood on your shirt.
Exactly. These are all within a couple miles of Griffith Park. I figure we divide and conquer. Should take us a couple hours. We'll ask the questions Centauri doesn't want to. If it doesn't work out, we'll go through the disgruntled cop interviews. She'll be none the wiser. Excuse me?
Yeah.
Sir?
Oh. Good morning. Start again. Looking for a man who checked in over the last week. Alone, but kept himself to himself, paid cash.
You just described pretty much everyone here.
All right, well, let's start last Wednesday and move forward. I'm gonna stay a couple nights, maybe still here.
That I would remember. See, we deal pretty exclusively in an hourly guest.
Enjoy the movie.
We found these at the bottom of the sleeping bag. We probably won't get any fresh.
And what about the rest of the room?
Well, it's an abandoned building. It's covered in 100 different sets of hairs, prints, fibers. We'll run what we get, but there's no good way to separate wheat from chaff.
I'm sorry, what were you doing in here again?
Based on old cases, we were checking out motels within a 2-mile radius of the first murder, seeing if anything popped.
Yeah, but this isn't a motel, so...
Well, no, but it's the opposite one, and I saw this building looked like the kind of place somebody might make camp.
Well, there are probably 6 abandoned buildings on this street alone, not to mention all the buildings across from the motels you checked out, any one of which someone could have camped out in. I'm just trying to understand what specifically brought you in here.
Doesn't matter. This is where the guy was. There were signs of a forced entry.
Lucky you were looking out for that kind of thing.
No, if I was lucky, I would have caught the guy.
And you never saw the suspect at all, is that right, Detective Byrd?
I was at another motel.
How did you guys decide who'd take which motels?
Well, we tore a piece of paper in half.
You did?
We did.
I did. What's your point?
I just want to make sure I completely understand how we all got here. But I think I'm up to speed now.
Excellent.
Thank you.
So, we have a perimeter set out. We've got Metro going door to door. Just going to have to wait and see what SID come up with, okay?
Good.
Does the Bureau have anything to add? No, that sounds exactly right to me.
Good, thank you.
Good night.
Excuse me, Captain. Can I talk to you for a moment? It's about Detective Brittany. When I asked you for those files on recently terminated, disgruntled, or troubled law enforcement officers, guess who was in the stack?
Are you saying that you think Detective Brittany is the suspect?
I'm saying that for someone the department has chosen to keep an eye on, Detective Brittany seems to have developed a pretty incredible knack for being in the right place at the right time.
Let me go get Rex. I'll drop him off at home. I'll be at the station in 30 minutes or less. Rex?
We got a call from someone claiming to be our guy.
What? What do you say?
Let's go. I'll play it for you.
Hello, Elizabeth. It's me. I'm wondering which feels worse. Knowing that a local cop got closer in one day than you did in 12 years, or knowing that someone's gonna have to rewrite the end of that book you've been slaving away at. After all we've been through, you were really going to credit someone else for my work? I thought we were closer than that.
That's it. Short. Did Nat have any luck with the trace?
Yeah. It took some work, but he was able to follow it back to its originating number. You recognize that number, Detective Britton?
Yeah. It's mine. We sent a team?
We did. We just need your consent to let them in.
Absolutely. Let's go.
No, hang on. Where have you been for the last hour?
I went to go home. I had to go. Why does it matter?
No one else in Los Angeles knows about that book, Detective.
you don't actually think that I made this call.
Look, no one is making any accusation.
No, she is.
No, we're just trying to put it all together.
Captain Gemini either is or was standing in my living room.
Gemini is dead, Detective.
You sticking with that? Even after everything we found?
What have we found? You're out running, you happen to find a body, which you point out meets all the publicly available work of a dead serial killer. Then I mention a $2 bill, you go back, and lucky you, find a $2
bill. Not luck, there was a dog at the crime scene.
And you get dispatched to follow a set of leads, and instead, you take your partner off in one direction, while you, alone again,
my son is home in a few hours.
Seemingly chosen at random from all the other buildings along your route, and lucky again, you find the killer. Then after he gets away, the killer drops us a line congratulating you on your good work. And of all the phones in the world he could use, he uses yours.
You think if it was me, I would be dumb enough to make a call from my own house?
I think you think you're smart enough to use a phone you think wouldn't be traceable.
If this guy wasn't at my house, then somehow he's redirected the call to make it look like it came from my house. Either way, he's got you two wasting your time looking at me, the only person who's made any headway in the case, while he's free to pick out his second victim.
All right, let's talk about victims. That guy you found in the park, turns out he's got a lengthy rap sheet for child abuse and sex offenses.
So what?
I wonder if you were a cop losing his marbles, if that's the kind of guy you might like to see disappear.
All right. You know what? That's enough.
Detective Britton, do we have your consent to search your home and your car?
Yes. Can we go?
You are not going anywhere.
You're running out of time. Then go and do it. Be aware of this fact. So while you're pulling through my drawers trying to find a way to tie me in, he's out there, free and clear, ready to deliver another body.
I drove down that street, Detective. There are at least four buildings that look like someone might have been squatting there. Why did you choose that one? Why did you choose the mountaintop moving and storage building over all of them?
I told you.
I know. And now I'm telling you, I need your weapon.
Where the hell have you been? I'm sitting here an hour. I don't hear a word from you. You don't answer the phone, nothing.
I was making sure Rex didn't come home while the SID team was tearing your place apart.
So what are you thinking?
You know what I'm thinking, Mike. I'm thinking I don't know why you were in that building either. I'm thinking that ever since you came back, you have been different, that we don't work as a team the way we used to. You playing hunches that you either can't or won't explain. You tell me you're going one way, you go the other. Then when I ask you about it, you say something thin and try to make it sound like I'm going crazy.
Do you think I had something to do with this?
If I thought you had something to do with it, I wouldn't be here. I'm just saying, don't pretend things are how they used to be. Now, they won't let me take anything from the evidence room. Best I can do are these photos. If you can pull a rabbit out the hat, now's the time.
Thanks. We get any prints back from these food items here?
No, nothing that came up in the database. A few partials, they don't know what matches. Who knows how many people handled that stuff?
All right, here we go. This napkin. You recognize that logo?
No, it's a napkin. Someplace with food. Gemini Killer has to eat, right?
Can we get Nat to do an image search? Please.
Bay Street Cafe. Gourmet coffee shop. Napkin. Mugs. You can go online and get a t-shirt with that thing on it, okay? 6 locations. So we got Pasadena, Culver City, South Bay, Venice, Brentwood, Malibu. They're all miles away from the store.
Yeah, all in proximity to a park.
So he gets a coffee while stalking his second victim?
Maybe.
Even if we pull all the units, all the other parks, and concentrate on this 6, I mean, we're still talking hundreds of acres.
We're missing something. You have the pictures of the first murder?
Huh? No.
Holy.
What?
In the background. Look at Santoro's cup. She had that with her when I picked her up in Brentwood.
Okay. The Brentwood location is in the lobby of the Meridian Hotel.
Which is where she's staying.
Hi, you got my voicemail. You know what to do.
I know you're not calling me back, but I'm just gonna keep leaving you messages because I'm your mom and I love you, and one of these days you're gonna appreciate that I kept trying.
Agent Santoro?
Yeah.
Special Agent Olivia Santoro, please leave a message after the beep.
She's not picking up. Come on. Okay, put out an attempt to locate on Agent Centaur. We need all units to respond to Temescal Canyon Park. Nobody goes in or out.
What are you doing, Bernie? You can't be out of there.
Sorry, sir. Park's closed tonight.
Why do you think I'm here?
Keep your eyes open in there.
Always.
Anybody come in or go out?
Just the FBI guy.
Except when it's 40
followers.
Elizabeth, did you really think Minturn was me, or did you just want it to end? See, you try to tell the world I'd failed. I'd lost. Do you have any idea how troubling that was?
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
Why didn't you tell me you called the movers?
Because I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed that I want this. That I need it. That when I got off the phone with the moving company, or when I got off the plane in Oregon, I felt hope. Like I haven't been able to for a long time. I don't know how you do it. I wish I could be as strong as you. That's just something you have, I don't. I know you think that I just want to run away, but I don't. I don't want to forget him. Part of Rex that I want to remember is right here. I see our son. I see who we were when we were with him. And what I dream we could be again. You think I want to leave that behind? You're crazy.
So you would move?
If that's what she needs, I'll make it work.
But you and Rex, you would stay here.
Yeah, he lives here. He goes to school here. He has his friends and tennis and... he doesn't want to move. What?
I don't want to give the wrong impression. I think this represents progress.
Imagine that.
I just fear that this progress is going to be more painful than you seem to understand.
Come on, check out that view. Two bedrooms. And they say it backs up to a nature preserve.
Wow. I think that your ability to maintain these two worlds relies heavily on the fact that they're largely the same. The visual priming that takes place as you move through this world helps you form the other.
What are you doing? Just enjoying the view? Look at that, it's beautiful. I think you're just gassed and you're afraid to admit it. Well, catch me.
But if your worlds are completely different, these connections will erode, and eventually, I think one will begin to seem more and more like what it is, a fantasy.
So you think if I am in two different places, one of them will fall apart?
Dreams are our way of processing reality. If you move, you're processing an entirely different world. Living in Oregon, your mind will eventually have to let go of L.A.
But understand, I think that this is a good thing. In your dream, you're beginning to recognize, to wrestle with the fact that there comes a point at which you have to move on. And you'll fight it, which is natural, it's healthy even. But sooner or later, I think you'll let go.
So you talk about me like I'm something you've studied before or read in a textbook, but you don't know. This thing works because I make it work. And nothing's gonna change that. I won't let it.
This is Breton.
Hello, Detective.
Who is this?
You know, it's very strange. For 12 years, no one's even come close, and then in 48 hours, you and I run into each other twice. I became terribly curious just who is this man, and what could be his secret. So I paid a visit to your therapist's office, and now I understand. Can you really not tell if you're awake or asleep? I bet they've told you that you're crazy, that you need help, that you need to get well. You see, that's the thing about guys like you and me. There's no other way for us to be. You take away what makes us us and what's left. Now, don't let them do that to you. The world needs a few of us to see it sideways. Sweet dreams, Detective Breton. And speaking just for myself, I'd be very disappointed if you woke up.